fishermen coming in from the sea. That could very well be Peter, Andrew, James, and John. Two boats.
This is Ellie Ron. He is the owner of the restaurant, family. And we are staying here at his hotel for the last 6 days, and they do a great job.
Very good. Thank you, Steve. Appreciate it. God bless you. Have a happy new year to all of us.
Thank you.
Good morning. Shalom from Galilee. We're headed to Capernaum to see where Jesus did most of his ministry today. We're going to spend some time on a boat, and then we're going to head off to Jerusalem. I'm here with my friend Damien, and we've been having a great time on this Footprints of God pilgrimage.
Yeah, it's been great, and I can't wait to be on the boat.
Adopted this idea because, which is a communist idea. Now, why do I say communist? Because everything in that style of life is.
Good morning. Getting everybody getting on the boat. Already taking their seats. Good morning. Good morning.
Hi.
Good morning.
Good morning, Steve.
You know, it really varies from year to year. I've had some Easters where it was 99 degrees, I've had 12 degrees going.
Today we'll give you the details of what we do, and then you can decide if you want to join us.
He spoke a little English, and he says, "You ask too many questions." He said, "If you want to know these things, then you come with us fishing tonight." Guess what I did? I was there at 6 o'clock in the evening. I helped them load their fishing boat. I got on the boat with Shimi and Pudi, and we took off in that boat up to the north coast, up there, the north shore, near Bethsaida. The sun was still up. We left at 6 in the evening. Set their nets.
Palestine, what is fresh and fish are in it. Splashes of green adorn its banks. Trees spread their branches over it and stretch out their thirsty arms.
After being on an actual boat, we take them to see a movie about the discovery of an ancient boat 2,000 years old. Could very well have been one Jesus was in. We just came in through this door, and we entered the Church of Capernaum, the memorial of Peter's house. And this is where Peter lived. Right down here, Jesus lived with him for 3 years here. Here we have Mass. And this was the place where Jesus said, "Eat my flesh and drink my blood." He said that right there
in that synagogue, and that's the reading of the gospel today. The worst sin God hates is idolatry, where you worship something else in place of Him. On the other hand, if I make fun of that and I just think it's bread and wine, but it's really the gift that God has given us, and it is His body and blood, then I'm going to be in trouble on that side because I'm neglected and made fun of. And I used to call it the cookie Christ. Do Catholics worship a cookie Christ? Well, I gave my talk on defending the Eucharist. The kids were up in the tree listening to me like squirrels from the branches of the tree. Josh said, "Hey, where's Jesus? I want to see him," pretending that he was Zacchaeus in the tree. What about you, Hannah?
Oh, I love it.
You guys like it? Oh, there goes Dominic's already eating a pita bread. Very cool. Nice salads. Tabbouleh, baba ganoush, corn, cabbage and peppers. Nice green salad, more cabbage, Turkish salad.
Starting to eat the St. Peter's fish.
You got the head off
already. I got the head up.
Yeah, I don't want it. Here's with the head on. That's the real deal.
Oh my gosh, we do have to take a picture.
I'm sure that priest thought I was crazy. He went up to the front and he began. We were totally lost. We had no idea what all this rigmarole and kneeling, and we didn't know any of the answers, the recitations, and with your spirit. We didn't know any of this. And Al Crest is handing us the missile. He said, "Here's the missile." I didn't know what a missile was. I thought that was something you shot to the moon. I had no idea what a missile was. And he's trying to, I said, "Look, I can't even see. I got tears in my eyes." I said, "Tell me later." I cried through the whole Mass. When that priest came up and I started to cry, I looked over at Janet and she had tears running down her cheeks and she was crying too. And her and I cried.
About an hour and a half into the drive, we stop at a rest area here where everybody gets ice cream and uses the restrooms and gets a coffee. It's a nice little break for 20 minutes, and then we get back on the bus and head the rest of the way down south, stopping first at Ein Kerem and then Jerusalem. Up the hill to the Visitation. This is Mary's last step. She's finally arrived. Our group arriving in the lower level of the Church of the Visitation is Zechariah, the priest offering the incense at the Ark of the Covenant. There's Mary meeting Elizabeth and the Holy Spirit. And here, very strange, is the slaughter of the innocents. And here is the rock that John the Baptist was hid behind. See there? To protect him from the slaughter. And this is the well. When Mary came, this is where she first met Elizabeth, and it's still a functioning well today. The artwork you just saw gives me the chance to show and demonstrate Mary as the Ark of the New Covenant from Scripture, Mary the Queen of Heaven, the Mother of the Church. This is an amazing place, and I love to give my half-hour talk here defending the doctrines of Mary.
Sherry, just wanted, and Karen and Dan, just wanted to say hi.
I wish you guys were here.
Yes, it is amazing. Amazing.
See, there's
castle.
That's a castle. You're right. See, there's Our Lady up there, and the Vatican flags flying to greet you. And this is where you're going to be called home. Well, we just arrived here in Jerusalem at the Catholic Notre Dame Center. There's Our Lady and holding baby Jesus, and the Vatican flags are flying. Beautiful hotel. Janet and I have been staying here for 21 years. Papal property, working and helping with the Christians. And here I'm going to go in. Our group has already been set up, and they're all got to their rooms, had time to freshen up a bit. Now I'll take you in, show you where they all are now. Having dinner, here's the beautiful lobby. Very free and powerful Wi-Fi. And here's the dining room. So here everybody is. We've been starving them, and finally they get to come to dinner.
Starving us? I had 5 big meals in a row.
And of course wine is also included with the meals. Here are our tables. Getting started. This area is for us, and this area, and there the wine is going around. We're all getting settled in.